Welcome to V8 Nation, talking all things motorsport with Rick Kelly and Paul Dumbrell.
PD, Rick, don't know how you do it. We had Sam Newman in a couple of weeks ago, but you continue along with the big TCL TVs, bring the big guests into the V8 Nation studio, and tonight's no exception.
Unbelievably, Cam, you've actually caught the same disease that Rick's got in terms of product placement, and everyone who's watched on YouTube can see the, what headphones are they, Rico?
Beats by Dr. Beats, Dre. Yeah. It's not as big as a TV screen.
No, absolutely not. No, we've been very, very fortunate to have some sensational guests in the show, in the studio, and also on the phone. But we've probably certainly got our most glamorous guest
for sure.
And one of the most highest profile as well.
Probably upset Rick too, because he now isn't the most attractive V8 Nation person in the studio tonight.
I didn't know he was.
That's coming from his mouth, so we're just going to take his word for it.
We've got Naomi Robson in the studio with us tonight. How are you going?
I'm really good. It's great to be here. Yeah, I'm in great company. Man, you guys are legends.
Thank you.
One thing we are good at.
If I could drive like you, I'd be like,
The only thing we're good at, I think, is crashing into one another, or more so me crashing.
Yeah, I've heard you're getting really good at
PD.
That.
Week in, week out, that's what I tend to do these days. But you've got a great interest in cars as well.
I have, yeah. I don't know why, but, you know, I've always been interested in cars and... I was just out last week at Phillip Island. BMW were very kind and generous to take me down there for a drive day, and just had a ball. Took out the M3s on the track, and it's an amazing thing to do.
Mm-hmm. And have you done a few drive days on a few different tracks?
I've done a couple. You know, yep. I was really lucky that by another car company that starts with M, it's not a BMW. The Mercedes, that was amazing too, because they actually let us out on the Grand Prix track.
Yeah, okay.
And it's actually the first time that they've let street cars onto a Grand Prix track when it's set up for racing.
Really?
So we went out there and they took instructors with us and we went round. And it's an amazing track. Yeah. So that was amazing. But I got to say, the BMW drive day was amazing because we had Jeff Brabham was instructing us. And it's such an incredible thing that they do. You basically, he's driving in front of you in an M3. I was behind him, and they've got, you know, radio mics in the car. So he's basically talking you through the whole track, and it just makes it so, it's just brilliant. It's such a great way of doing it because you're in the car and he'll tell you the race lines, all that kind of stuff, and you just get faster and faster. You know, he starts off, you know, at nana pace, and then it's like, mate, just move over. Let me just have a go at this, you know. It was extraordinary. It was so much fun.
And Phillip Island would have to be outside of Bathurst. Would have to be the best fun from a driver's perspective as well. So to be able to get on there in a road car, and especially, you probably really couldn't call an M3 a road car. It's nearly like a race car. We talked about it before the show. It's so nimble. You can throw it into the corners.
It's amazing. Like, I took round one of their other cars, and the comparison was just... Yeah. Depressing. You know, I mean, that's not to be mean, but just to say that the M3 is so good. It really is. Yeah. You know, I mean, you can get on the brake. You can just jump on those brakes and just take off. It's an amazing car. Yeah. I had so much fun.
It's an interesting thing doing a drive day, particularly at such a fast track like Phillip Island. The speaker system sounds like a good idea to give everyone an idea of how to, I guess, attack each lap. But was there any dramas? I mean, you take the general...
Oh, there were a couple of people vomiting. No, I'm not kidding.
Really?
Because we had to double up in some of the cars, and some of the poor passengers didn't quite handle the G-forces around that sweeper, you know? It's like, whoopsie. You know, like, we sort of pulled up, it's like these guys are hanging out of the car. So, yeah, it does unfortunately happen. Just what you don't want to do in your M3, I give you the tip. But, it's an amazing experience,
And for everyone who doesn't know, you've actually had your own CAMS license before.
I did, which has lapsed, sadly.
So we don't need to tell you on that, that's fine.
Damn it, yeah, but I did. Yep. And so I actually learnt at Sandown, that's where I did my training, and did a little bit of Targa Tasmania for a couple of days and done a couple of rallies, you know, the Dutton Rally, to the Adelaide Grand Prix, which was just hysterical.
Yeah. It's a good event, that one, for sure.
Oh, it was brilliant. Yeah, it was so much fun.
How do you find the rallies? Like, it's something which I've always loved to have possibly tried one day, maybe after my full-time racing's finished, because it seems like so much fun. It's completely different, it seems, from our point of view.
It is.
Completely different atmosphere. It's more laid back. Everyone's there to have a good time.
It's totally laid back. And you feel like real hoons, because, you know, you're all there with these, you know, stuff all over your car, you know, like, you know, stickers, all kinds of stickers and crap and everything. And so you're all driving along and there's this real sense of community. And of course, you're blocking off roads, really nice thing to do, and just speeding around the place, which is just great fun. But when I did Targa, it was so funny because I had this navigator who unfortunately wasn't the best navigator of all time. He's a really good guy, but Jesus Christ, we're flying along at 200 k's down, and I'm looking at, and I could not see. I didn't know whether we were going left or right. I'm going left or right, and he's going, I don't know. I'm going, nice one. Thanks, guy. I'm like, okay, you clearly want to die. You know, I mean, hello, left or right, isn't that hard? You got to, like, set yourself up for these corners. But, God, it was loads of fun. I mean, that was the year when I think it was Dick Johnson came off. You know, he was driving a Beretta at the time, that little pocket rocket thing. Just went straight off an embankment, you know.
Really?
And someone came up to him and said, oh, mate, you must be unhappy about that. He goes, oh, no, it's not. I didn't crash it. It's just parked badly. You know? And then he had Sir Jack Brabham, who managed to wedge his car on a side, on its side between two trees. Had to climb out through the sunroof.
It's unpredictable, isn't it?
It's really dangerous. You've got to know what you're doing down there.
What about on the normal road? What sort of driver are you? You're out there, you're more of an angry driver, swerving in and out of traffic, nice and relaxed?
I'm so sedate. Because, look, the thing is, when you do a lot of driving, as you know how long it takes to stop a car, really, in the wet or whatever. And, you know, that's another thing they did at that BMW drive day, is like stopping the emergency braking. And the difference between going, you know, 30 k's, 50 k's and 80 k's, unbelievable. Yep. I mean, you know, to bring that car to a stop.
Yeah.
So I'm just like full. I mean, I'm so anal about it that I'll put on the cruise control to make sure I stay in the speed limit.
Yeah.
It's there for a reason. Respect other people. It's not, go out on a track if you can, you know.
Yeah, definitely.
What about in the car parks? Are you racing around, parking in between two cars, slamming your door?
No.
Park it over in the corner.
Wouldn't that be great? I just love that. No, unfortunately not. Is that what you do? Actually, I've heard that you do that.
Yeah, you should have seen him parked outside the show. It was he nearly swerved and out to the footpath. And I got him a Subway cookie and I dropped the cookie. It was just diabolical.
The car's actually still at the front half on the curb running.
It's all good fun.
So we love aviation, and both Rick and I have got our helicopter licenses. But we might have heard a whisper that you've actually raced a car versus a jet.
Yeah, exactly. I was so lucky. Porsche had the GT4 coming into Australia years ago, a couple of years ago anyway, and. Today, tonight, they called and said, look, we know that Naomi's sort of a bit into that racing thing. Would she like to race against an A4 Skyhawk jet? And the New Zealand Navy at Nowra in New South Wales have, you know, that's where they do a lot of their training. Yep. So I'm like, rat up a drainpipe. Yeah, you know, like, so I was just, but it was the hardest thing to do because you've got this screaming jet. I mean, talk about screaming. This thing, they literally just get it up to full power, which is 9,000 pounds of thrust, right?
Yep.
You cannot hear your car. You can't hear anything. The ground is literally shaking.
Unbelievable.
And it was unbelievable. And of course, did I redline it? Yeah, because I couldn't, you know, I don't know about you, but I, you know, when I'm going through the gears, I do it by sound more than anything.
Yeah, you like to hear it for sure.
And couldn't hear the engine. So I'm like, redline. Okay, so I missed that. It wasn't so good. But you know, I got to say, although my camera crew were on my side, let's face it, and they were right at the quarter mile because it was a quarter mile sprint.
Yep.
And but this thing literally just sat on its backside when he let it go, just went boom and then whoom and just tore. I mean, it was just tearing along the tarmac. I'm like, you know, like, I don't know which way to look. But our camera crew said, no, it was a dead heat.
Really?
The pilot reckons, nah, we won, like, for sure. And they sneakily had put in as little fuel as possible in this thing, so it wasn't that heavy. You know, they'd made it as light as they possibly could, you know, just for a couple of, you know, turns and round, and they did a couple of touch and goes and all of that. But, it was pretty exciting. Yeah.
Definitely. Lining up next to a jet, PD, with that amount of noise, you'd want to really keep to one side, wouldn't you? You don't want to get stuck underneath that.
Yeah, well, luckily we're both on different runways. It was pretty exciting. And just, I think that's some of the thrill of motorsport, the sound of the engine and all that kind of stuff. Yeah. And sound of this, you know, Skyhawk was pretty exciting.
So what about the celebrity race at the GP? Is that something that you...
I've never had a chance to do it.
But you'd love to? Or?
I would love to, yeah, of course. But every time, of course, I worked for the wrong network obviously,
yeah, sure.
Every time.
Yep, yep.
And every time I was invited, Ron Walker invited me, you know, a couple of years yes. running, but of course Seven said no, and, yep. you know, and the network broadcaster that was broadcasting at the time, whether it was 9 yep. or 10, just went, nah. but Ron was very kind to at least invite me, but, you know, and it's a week off work, really, yeah. realistically, because, yeah. yeah. you know, you sort of...
Yeah, you've got to go through the lessons, and I think with different yeah. drivers and down to the track, it would be fun to do, that's
for
sure.
Oh, it'd be great fun.
Yeah. Rico, you know, after your performance for the last 2 weeks, maybe you should go get some driver coaching
yeah,
as well.
Yeah, go get some driver coaching, yeah.
I think I need it.
It's hard to say. He did win the race and I finished 19th. So yeah. probably shouldn't throw stones from glass houses. But hey, it's all right.
There's probably a good reason you were 19th because yeah. I punted yeah. you
but
off.
You know, there's one thing that I wanted to ask you guys while I've got you here, because, you know, I don't get the chance to grab hold of you V8 drivers that often, is that, you know, when you're racing and they say, look, you need to keep a sort of nice sort of calm posture and all that kind of stuff. But there's a certain sense of when you're... you know, tearing around a track, you are to a certain extent fighting with the wheel a little bit, aren't you? You know, I mean, yep. it's really sort of you're battling it out. So how do you keep your upper body sort of without tightening up? You know how you get that? And you'll see some people who are literally like this. And I notice that I get into that when it gets faster and faster. You know, down that bottom sweeper at Phillip yep. Island, I'm like, yep. hang on, guys, we'll get round. And the car's sitting out on its backside and stuff.
I think
how
a lot
do
of
you
that.
Do that?
Well, like, I think a lot of that actually comes to the seating position. Our cars are built definitely around us from pouring a two-part foam seat that molds to our body to having the steering wheel. So you can really attack it nicely. But
okay.
even when we're struggling with a track or with our car set up, we're still very tense behind the wheel. And after a few laps, you do tend to still get quite sore. But it's just more and more laps, I guess, isn't it, PD?
You've got to really be conscious. There's sometimes, like on a qualifying, on top 10 shootout lap,
yeah.
you'll come across, you'll warm up the tyres on your out lap, and you'll get halfway down the main straight, and you'll think
yeah,
that you are
on.
Literally just holding the steering wheel as tight as you can, and you sort of just go relax down and just take a deep breath.
And just let it go, yeah.
So, motorsport fan, are you an F1 fan, motorbike
Definitely
fan,
F1.
V8 fan?
Motorbike, not so much.
Yep.
Yeah,
yep.
although I do go down to Phillip Island to watch the GP course.
GP,
yeah,
yep.
why would you not?
Yep.
And that's great, but for me, on bikes, it's just you and the road. I'm like,
yep.
I prefer to be in a car,
yep.
you
yep.
know.
Yeah.
I feel much more comfortable. And I really enjoy driving cars.
Yes.
I like the sense of having some skill about driving properly and, you know, being able to drive fast.
A bit of roll cage around you. Unless it's like PlayStation where you can turn the damage control off, roll cage is good.
Now, just before we let you go, Naomi, off air we were talking about Rick's TV show that they're currently working on and sounds very exciting. And you said, I'd love to drive at Bathurst. This could be an opportunity for
Absolutely.
You to put a bit of pressure on Rico to say, come on, give me a drive. Come on, Rick.
Well, I thought that was the deal, that I come
for
in
sure.
here and then he organises a drive to
Bathurst. So did I. That's what I thought.
That's what I was told. That's the only reason why
definitely.
I'm here.
I am happy with that. If you can definitely get the licence, we would love to have you on board our TV show. There's no doubt about it. So glad
Forget
we got
the TV show.
Done.
Just get her on the grid at Bathurst.
Just, yeah, that's
straight
that's
to the grid.
Straight to the grid.
Straight to the grid. Gosh, it would be great fun. You must have so much fun.
Yeah, look, even with Bathurst.
And you've had so much success there too. Gosh.
It's a big event, and we even racing there, PD, you've probably raced it 12 times, 13 times.
Yep.
You still turn up. The first practice session is still daunting and makes us nervous. And the grid, I get so nervous on the start of Bathurst grid, even though we've been there for so long. It's definitely
an
incredible event.
And, yeah, like, you know.
Back when I was younger, I won it a couple of times.
Back to back.
Back to back.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
That's extraordinary.
Back
it
a long
really
time,
is.
Though. That was back when it was.
You. It's so,
thank
that
you.
Really is amazing.
TV was black and white back then.
Yeah, yeah. No need to live in the past, mate. No need to live in the past.
That's the funniest thing he's ever said.
Yeah, I know.
In 15
you
weeks.
Call it quits, Rico. Yeah.
I'm out.
He has no doubt been saving up for you, Naomi.
I appreciate it too.
Appreciate your time coming into the V8 Nation studio.
Oh, it's a pleasure.
We look forward to you, one, driving a Bathurst in Rick's team
of
a little bit later in the year
and
having you back in the studio to talk motorsport real soon.
Fantastic. Thanks for having me.
Thank you very
much.
Thanks
a lot.
This is V8 Nation with Rick Kelly and Paul Dumbrell.